I humbly entreat thee for the soul of this thy servant, Neil Howie, who will today depart from this world. Do not deliver me into the enemy's hands. Oh, put me out of mind forever. Let me not undergo the real pains of hell, dear God, because I die unshriven. And establish me in that bliss which knows no ending. Through Christ, our Lord.
Thank you. That is good. For believing what you do, we confer upon you a rare gift these days. A martyr's death. You will not only have life eternal, but you will sit with the saints among the elect. Come, it is time to keep your appointment with the Wicker Man.
It's an earthquake. We've had them already.
Stay with your wings. Come on, stay.
We'll be right back. Hanging in the atmosphere, the clouds of debris shut out the sun's heat and light. Across large areas of the northern hemisphere, it starts to get dark. It starts to get cold. In the centers of large land masses like America or Russia, the temperature drop may be severe, as much as 25 degrees centigrade. Even in Britain, within days of the attack, it could fall to freezing or below for long, dark periods. The stresses of hypothermia, epidemic, and radiation fall heavily on the very young and the old. Their protective layers of flesh are thinner. In the first few winters, many of the young and old disappear from Britain.